Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Two very important questions before we get right to the topic. One question you may know the answer to easily, but the second question, maybe not many people know of it. What's the first question? Brothers and sisters, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create us? What is the goal of our creation? I know some of you know this. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created the jinn or the human beings except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Excellent. Allah created us to worship Him. Top question number two. What is the goal of worshiping Allah? Excuse me. What is the goal of all goals? غَايَةُ الْغَايَاتِ What is it? It is nothing but to achieve taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The goal of every act of worship, the goal of every ibadah is to attain taqwa, brothers and sisters. That's the goal of all goals. Brother, give us a proof. All right, siyam, you're fasting, right? طيب. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, fasting has been made an obligation upon you and upon those before you. Why, Ya Allah, we have to do this ibadah? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So you may attain taqwa. And that's the goal of all goals. Allah says, Ya أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ The first call in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah. O people, Ya أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اُعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ Worship Allah, the one who created you and created those before you. Why, Ya Allah, worship? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Allahu Akbar. So that's the ultimate goal, brothers and sisters. And yes, I think you got to know now what's our third group. They are al-muttaqin. Al-muttaqin, they are of the blessed groups that Allah says that He loves them, brothers and sisters. And Allah says that He loves al-muttaqin three times in the Quran. But before we go to the verses, I want your undivided attention. Please, why? Because we have to define what does taqwa mean. Be patient with me. It's very important. What does taqwa mean? Are you guys ready? Yalla, bismillah. Taqwa comes from the word wiqayah, which is protection. Taqwa comes from the word wiqayah, which is protection. So when I say ittaqi, it means protect yourself. Ittaqi. So we say ittaqi al-corona. You know, have taqwa of corona. So what do? For example, you wear a mask, right? So when we say اتَّقِ اللَّهِ means put between you and Allah's anger. اتَّقِ اللَّهِ put between you and Allah's wrath and punishment a barrier. اجعل بينك وبين عذاب الله وقايا. In the example we mentioned about the virus and the corona, what's that barrier? It's this mask, right? It's this mask. That's your barrier. طيب, what's the barrier between you and Allah's punishment? What can protect you from that? فِعْلُ طَاعَتِهِ وَاجْتِنَابُ مَعَاصِيهِ It is the obedience to Allah in doing what He told you to do and staying away from the things that Allah told you to stay away from. So this means the more you do what Allah told you to do and the more you are far away from what Allah told you to stay away, the bigger the barrier, the more taqwa, protection you have, right? So what Allah says in the Quran, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ Be conscious of Allah and be fearful of Allah's punishment as much as it deserves. So as much taqwa, all in, all the way possible. May Allah increase your taqwa and my taqwa. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. All right. So it says doing the obligations and staying away from the prohibitions. Give me a second, please. So when I say taqwa and the aspect of prohibitions and so on, taqwa is a big circle. There's a lot of things we have to do. There's a lot of things. For example, being good to our parents is one of them. Praying is one of them. This is all part of taqwa. Okay, what else? Paying my zakah, it's part of taqwa. So taqwa is a big circle. All this is taqwa. What you will notice, and please pay attention, out of all the things that we have to do, part of taqwa, all three ayat that talks about Allah loves al-muttaqeen focuses on one specific amal salih, good deed. Wow, before I tell you what it is, this good deed Allah's focusing on as part of taqwa has to be a serious big deal. Yes, anybody here watching us knows what is it? What's that obligation that we have to do that Allah honored so much in all three ayat? Allah says, I love al-muttaqeen. I love al-muttaqeen. Those who do this. Allahu Akbar. What is it? Yalla, people of the Quran, what is it? It is, brothers and sisters, may Allah protect us all, may Rabbil Alameen, it is the fulfilling of contracts. Al-wafa bil-ahd. Being faithful to your promise. Faithfulness, if you want to choose one word. Al-wafa bil-ahd. Brother, give me an ayah. Give me something. One of the three ayat. Allah says, Bala man awfa bi-ahdihi. The one who fulfills the contract, is faithful to his promises, wattaqa, and was mindful of Allah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Then Allah loves those who have taqwa. Allahu Akbar. You see that, brothers and sisters? How are you with your promises? With all honesty, how is your fulfilling of promises? How is your fulfillment of your covenants and your contracts? So you know what Allah is teaching you and I? The more faithful you are, the higher your taqwa is. I think this is very clear now. The more faithful you are, the higher your taqwa is. And the lower it is, the lower the taqwa is. No, 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 it gets worse. The lower your wafa, your level of faithfulness, bil wafa, bil ahd, wal contract, and so on, it's a sign of nifaq. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. Yes, the worst category of human beings ever on earth are the munafiqeen, the hypocrites. May Allah protect you and I from them. So why do you say the ones who are unfaithful? Because that's how big of a deal it is in Islam. Brother, give me a proof. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, excellent. He says, ayatul munafiqi thalath. The signs of the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, are three. One of them, idha wa'ada akhlaf. Whenever they make a promise, they break the promise. Anytime they make a promise, it's just they have a hard time fulfilling it. May Allah protect us. Ameer Rabbil Alameen. I'm not saying because something happened. No, it's from within themselves, whether laziness, carelessness, you name it. And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says about the sign of the munafiq, وَإِذَا عَاهَدَ غَدَرْ. And whenever they have a contract, they make a promise, they have a covenant, they breach it. Ghadar, they are treacherous, they are unfaithful. May Allah protect us, brothers and sisters. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He says about, yes, those who are faithful, let me give you an example from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ready? Check this beautiful, beautiful, amazing story. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? ذَكَرَ رَجُلًا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. There was a man from the children of Israel. This man, he wanted 1,000 dinar, a large amount of money, as a loan. سأل بعض بني إسرائيل أن يسلفه ألف دينار. Okay, he was asking around, can I have 1,000 dinar? And not many people were actually able to support until he found that one guy. When he found this one guy, he says, give me the 1,000. He says, I will. But he asked for two things. Number one, سأل لشيئين. قال ائتني بالشهداء أشهدهم. So the man who has 1,000 dinar, he wants to give it to the brother who is asking for the loan. I will give it to you, but I want some witnesses to be with us. So then that man said, كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. The man who wants the money said, Allah is enough of a witness. Okay. So then the man who is about to give the 1,000 dinars says, okay, so question number two, فَأْتِنِي بِالْكَفِيلِ. Give me someone who will back you up in case you cannot pay the $1,000. The 1,000 dinar. Give me someone who can back you up. Someone that you can entrust with this. So that man says, كَفَى بِاللَّهِ كَفِيلًا. Allah is sufficient for me. Allah will back me up, inshallah. قَالَ صَدَقْتُ. So the man honored that, yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough of a witness, and Allah is enough to fulfill the trust and being able to back you up for the 1,000 dinar. فَدَفَعَهَا إِلَيْهِ إِلَىٰ أَجْلٍ مُسَمَّى. Then they had this what, brothers and sisters? They had this contract. Fantastic. When they had this contract, they had a due date. So the 1,000 dinar, you have to pay it back to me. I'll give you an example. In 6 months, for example, or whatever the time may be. So then that man who took the 1,000 dinar, خرج في البحر. He traveled, crossed the sea, فقضى حاجته. He went, did his job. Maybe he opened up a business. So he's overseas, if you wish to say. Okay? He traveled, did his thing. Everything is well. And now time has passed. Time has passed. وقد جاء الأجل. The due date has come. This man came to the seashore waiting for a boat to ride on to go back to that brother and give him the 1,000 dinar. So far, so good. Alhamdulillah. ثم التمس مركبا يركبها. Waiting and waiting. There are no boats. يقدم عليه للأجل. I want to pay my debt. No boat is available. Not a single boat. So this man got nervous. What should I do? What should I do? He's looking around. What should I do? So then he found a piece of wood. خشبة. Okay. فأخذ خشبة. فنقرها. He drilled a hole into that piece of wood. فأدخل فيها ألف دينار. He put into that hole, in that piece of wood, 1,000 دينار. That's a large amount of money. وصحيفة or وصحيفة منه إلى صاحبه. And he wrote a letter and put it inside that piece of wood. Perhaps he wrote, you know, my name is so-and-so, I'm paying off this 1,000. I was trying to look for a boat, I couldn't find one. So he wrote a note that I'm paying this 1,000 back to you. طيب. ثم رجح زجج موضعها. Then he locked that hole, sealed it very well. You got probably like super glue and all that stuff. You might think, okay, what is he trying to do? I'm coming, inshallah. ثم أتي or أتى بها إلى البحر. He came to the ocean and he did this. فقال. And he started speaking. So he has this piece of wood with him and now he's making dua to Allah. Ready? He says, اللهم إنك تعلم أني كنت تسلفت فلانا ألف دينار. Oh Allah, you know that I took 1,000 dinar from that brother. And he asked me, فسألني كفيلة. He asked me, who will be the one who can back you up? And I said, it's you, Ya Allah. And he was pleased with that. فرضي بك. Then he asked me for a witness. And I told him, Ya Allah, you are enough of a witness. And he was pleased with that. وإني جهدت أن أجد مركبا. Ya Allah, I was struggling to find a boat to be able to pay that loan back to the brother. Ya Allah. وإني أستودعكها. And Ya Allah, I entrust you with this money and that you will help return it to the man. فرمى بها في البحر. He grabbed a piece of wood and he threw it all the way into the ocean. ولجت فيه. Until it went so far away. ثم انصرف. Then this man left. Like, so you might be asking, like, so what is this brother thinking? Like, the piece of wood will cross the entire sea and reach the guy, مشعرف, and he will find it. Let's see. ثم انصرف. وهو في ذلك. And I want you to not forget this following point. This man who threw the piece of wood to pay back the loan on the due date, he doesn't want to be late. I gave a promise. I want to be faithful. الوفاء بالعهد. Right? A sign of taqwa, inshallah. While he threw that piece of wood, he was still waiting for a boat. You see that? Taking the means. الأخذ بالأسباب. وهو في ذلك يلتمس مركبة يخرج إلى بلده. To wait until he travels to the other country. He's not going to throw the wood and just wait and say, I threw the piece of wood. He's waiting for the boat. The other guy in the other country or land, he left his house and he's waiting for the guy to come back to pay him his money back. ينظر لعل مركبا قد جاء بماله. Maybe he gave it to someone to deliver the money. No one came. No one is showing up. فإذا بالخشبة التي فيها المال. All of a sudden, that man who owns the money, he saw the piece of wood across. So he went down or so and he picked up that piece of wood. Why did he pick it up? He wants to use it لأهله حطبة, as you know, to use it for firing, you know, to cook some food, maybe warm up in the fireplace, whatever the necessity behind it. So then he grabbed that piece of wood. ثم نشرها. And he started to cut the piece of wood. While he's cutting it, what did he see in it? The money and what else? The money and, yes, the letter. The money and the letter. والصحيفة. So he start reading the letter. You know, I'm so and so, or whatever was written on it to detail what happened. Then, brothers and sisters, he took this money. After some time, guess what happened? The man who was waiting for the boat to ride on and come and deliver the 1,000 dinar, he finally found a boat. He does not know what happened. He got on the boat. and he's traveling overseas to meet the brother who loaned him the 1,000 dinar. After he met him, he says, here is your 1,000 dinar. Wallahi ma ziltu jahida, I swear I struggled so much. I'm sorry for being late, but I struggled so much to find a boat. And I finally found one to give you this money. And I didn't find any boat till now. It's not like, you know, I missed 2-3 boats. No, that was the only boat I found since the due date. So then the man, when he heard that, he says, هَلْ كُنْتَ بَعَثْتَ إِلَيَّ بِشَيْءٍ? Did you ever send something to me? So the man says, أُخْبِرُكَ, I'm telling you, did not find any boat besides this. I just came on the first boat available. So the man says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَدَّى عَنْكَ الَّذِي بَعَثْتَ فِي الْخَشَبَةِ. Allah has fulfilled what you have sent to me and you put in that piece of wood. I got the money and I got your letter. فَانْصَرِفْ بِالْأَلْفِ دِنَارِ رَاشِدًا. So he told him, that 1,000, the extra 1,000 that you came all the way with to here, take it back with you. May you stay guided and be on the right path. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah ﷺ is telling us this authentic hadith, sahih, to appreciate how fulfilling we should be and faithful to our promises, brothers and sisters. How is your amana? How is your faithfulness? How is your wafa' bil-ahd? There's a lot that can be said, brothers and sisters. And one of the fruits, one of fawaid, wa thamarat al-taqwa, wal wafa' bil-ahd, is what Allah said. You see what happened to the brother? We know. We perhaps all know the ayah, or most of us. وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever has taqwa of Allah, is mindful of Allah, is trying to protect himself from Allah's punishment, Allah will always find an exit for you, brothers and sisters. Not just that. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And Allah will provide you with means in a way that you've never imagined. Just fulfill the amana, fulfill the contract, be faithful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and especially to your promises to people. Because I have to warn you. Naam, I have to warn you. I gave you hope, I showed you how Allah can take care of you, but I have to give you a hadith here. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man akhada, whoever, take what? أموال الناس يريد أداءها أدى الله عنه. Whoever takes money from the people, you take a loan. You take money, you can take a pen, you can take something, all right? And you have the intention, you make the intention, and you work hard towards it to pay off the debt, Allah will help you pay off the debt. It's a promise from Rasulullah ﷺ on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will make it easy for you to pay it off. And if you happen to die before paying it off and you tried, Allah will take care of you and the one who owes, the one who owns that money, the one who that money belongs to. Allah will take care of both of you. Allahu Akbar. طيب, where's the fear factor? The next half. وَمَنْ أَخَذَ يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا أَتْلَفَهُ اللَّهُ. And whoever took the wealth of people, you took a loan, and you already made up your mind. And wallahi, there are people like that. The more I grow, and the older I get, the more I realize there's such human beings on earth like that. They already made up their mind. They ask you, brother, عندك ألف, you have $1,000? And they already made up their mind, I'm not paying it back. Then Allah says, if you did that, I will ruin you. I will destroy you. You will not find any benefit in that money in the dunya, in addition to the punishment in the akhirah. I remember, subhanAllah, this one brother. I was telling him, I was trying to come between two people to solve a matter. So one brother loaned another brother some money. So when that brother took the money, the one who gave it said, I want it back. So the other brother says, no, I'm not giving it back. So then the first brother who gave that money called me. He says, can you please talk to him? And 1, 2, and 3 and stuff like that. We got witnesses and so on. So then I called the other brother. I said, this man gave you money. That's correct. He said, eventually he said yes. He was arguing, but eventually said yes. I did take the money. I said, that brother wants the money back. You know what this guy said? Wallahi, he's a loser. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But that statement is a loser statement. This man said to me, why does he need that money? For example, $1,000. He's a multi-millionaire. He's so rich. Why does he want the money for? And Inta, you already had it planned that, you know, it's only $1,000. He's a multi-millionaire, so I won't have to give it back. No, Allah will ruin you. Allah will ruin you if that's your intention, as Rasulullah has taught us. So beware, brothers and sisters. May Allah protect us Ameen Rabbil Alameen. May Allah protect us and make sure. You know what's the problem with that brother? He didn't have to call me, but that brother did not have a contract. So make sure, wallahi, even if it was your sibling, no matter who it is, have a contract when you go to be able to be faithful to it, because subhanAllah, shaitan comes and the evil in ourselves comes and says, oh, I didn't take it, or I don't know what happened, or oh, I forgot. La, have a contract as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in the longest ayah in the Quran, chapter 2, verse 282, ayatul dayn, right? May Allah make us faithful, ameen rabbil alameen. And you will see the two other ayat of three about Allah loving al-muttaqeen has to do with being faithful to the contracts. You're like, man, this is serious, yes. And I know some younger people may be watching us and they feel like, you know, I don't have that many contracts. No, you do have a contract, right? For sure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He said, la ilaha illallah, you signed a contract, right? Verbally. May Allah allow us to fulfill that. But also when it comes to people around you, when you went to school, right? You perhaps signed something which all indicates you will follow the rules of the school. You will not cheat in your exams. People who work as engineers and doctors, there's contracts. You fulfill that. This is part of our deen. Because the next two ayat, Allah's talking to us, or to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers, the sahaba, to fulfill the contracts towards some of the most evil people on earth. Na'am. Allah says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ عَاهَدْتُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَنْقُصُوكُمْ شَيْئًا وَلَمْ يُظَاهِرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ أَحَدًا فَأَتِمُّوا إِلَيْهِمْ عَهْدَهُمْ إِلَى مُدَّتِهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah says, as for the polytheists, the mushrikeen, these people don't love Rasulullah, don't love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah says, as long as they did not go ahead and try to fight you and they breached the contract, then fulfill the contract towards them. By the way, this was being revealed, and Rasulullah overall was getting stronger and stronger. So he has the upper hand. Yes, you probably are remembering the second group, Al-Muqsitin. That's part of it as well. But being faithful to the contract, brothers and sisters. You know what some of the people of Bani Israel, they used to say, and it's Surah Ali Imran. They used to say, you know what? That the Arab, which is the Bedouins at that time, that they're not worthy to give the money back to them. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows that this is very disrespectful. What an understanding. Like some people, may Allah forgive us. Yes, they have to be honest. Some people say, yeah, he had a kafir. This guy is a disbeliever. This guy talks bad about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will not fulfill the contract. Who said that? Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-mushrikeen Allah spoke about too. You gotta fulfill it. You know what? Forget the example of a doctor, engineer. Let me go back to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In one of the most amazing, wallahi al-azim, moments of faithfulness I've ever came across, Rasulullah sallam. Check this out. Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, a great sahabi, okay, along with his father. What's the story? قال ما منعني, the only reason I did not fight in the Battle of Badr. Battle of Badr, you all have to know something. Battle of Badr is the most elite battle. Whoever participated in the Battle of Badr are the grandest, best of the best of Sahaba, radiallahu anhum. That's it. These people say, hada badri. This guy showed up to Battle of Badr, the first major battle. Okay, so it's a big deal. Okay, what happened? He says, I did not go and participate for one reason only. Why? Me and my father, when we were trying to go to Medina, emigrate, escape, we want to go from Mecca, travel all the way up to Medina. Okay, what happened? فَأَخَذَنَا كُفَّارُ قُرَيْشِ, the disbelievers from Quraysh, they took us as like hostages. قَالُوا إِنَّكُمْ تُرِيدُونَ مُحَمَّدًا, you guys are trying to go and be with Muhammad. Isn't that right? فَقُلْنَا مَا نُرِيدُ إِلَّا الْمَدِينَةِ, we're not looking to go participate with Muhammad and fight you guys. No, we just want to go to Medina. We just want to emigrate to the other city. فَأَخَذُوا مِنَّا عَهْدَ اللَّهِ وَمِيثَاقَهِ, so we made a contract, a promise. What's a promise? لَنَنْصَرِفَنَّ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ وَلَا نُقَاتِلْ مَعَهِ, أي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they said, we made a contract that we will go to Medina and we will not fight in this battle of Badr with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can you imagine this? So far so good? You're like, yeah bro, just, you know, say yeah, I promise, and then go and support Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَأَتَيْنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, then we saw the Prophet ﷺ and they want to go participate in the Battle of Badr. I have to give you one more detail about the Battle of Badr. The numbers. The numbers, Kuffar Quraysh were 1,000. The Muslims were about 315 approximately or so. 300 plus, that's it. So any additional person is very important. Every additional person. Because it's like 1-to-3 ratio. So then Hudhayfa and his father, radiallahu anhuma, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to join. But they told him of the story. You know, we got away with it. Kuffar Quraysh, they took us and they said, you guys, we'll let go of you, go to Medina by promise. You don't fight with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he heard that. He said, insarifa. What? He told them, Hudhayfa, leave the army. Do not participate. Ya Rasul, this is, the life is on the line. This is like, there's the life and death situation. Faithfulness, brothers and sisters, I mean in terms of battle, life and death situation, some people will say, oh, that's an extreme example, besides that one. It's a battle. In sarifa, go away, it's okay. Nafi lahum bi'ahdihim, we will fulfill the promise, we will be faithful. وَنَسْتَعِينُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِمْ And we will seek Allah's assistance against them. Brothers and sisters, Battle of Badr. And Allah knows best, this was one of the means of the victory of Muhammad ﷺ and the Sahaba, and they beat the thousand of the disbelievers. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا Allahu Akbar. You see that when you're faithful, Allah will never turn you down, brothers and sisters. Do you know, brothers and sisters, do you know an example of the Prophet ﷺ about faithfulness to the contract, even when we, for example, buy and sell? What do you mean buy and sell? Yes, when we go buy and sell a house. Brother, you jump from a battle all the way to real estate. Yes, because a contract is a contract. Yalla, let's go buy a new house. Are you guys ready, inshallah? I hope you like this house. Somewhere in Arizona, because these, I think called shingles, right? They have a special way of being designed. Anyhow, so this house, what's up with this faithfulness? Rasulullah tells us an amazing story. Wallahi, the story is about wafa and the taqwa and the faithfulness aspect, fulfilling the contract is just amazing. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, there were two groups of people. Okay, what's happening? One guy was selling his house. So a buyer comes, checks the house, he likes the house, and he says, you know what? I want to go ahead and buy the house. Okay, fantastic. So far, so good. So he buys the house and he moves in with his family. When he moved inside the house, guess what he found in it? He found jarrah fiha dhahab, like a bowl full of gold. Imagine gold, not like a piece, no, a whole pot of gold. Then this man, honestly, can I ask you a question? Feel free to comment if you wish, yani. If you bought a house, okay, and you found a pot full of gold in it, what will you do? أطعمني الله وسقاني, right? This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is it. This is a sign that Allah loves me. This is the barakah. What would you do? Listen to what Rasulullah says about this story. This guy bought the house. He moved in. He found a whole pot full of gold. Okay, full of gold. So then this man went to the seller, to the original or the previous owner. He says, hey, I found a pot of gold. I believe that's yours. What would you do if you were the seller? Oh, jazakallahu khayran. I actually forgot about this, right? Jazakallahu khayran. I'm not saying it's right or wrong, by the way. Both people are inshallah right, inshallah, okay? But I'm just telling you, what would you do? So the previous owner said, oh, this pot of gold, it's now yours. Why? Because I sold you the house and basically whatever is in it. I sold you the house as is. So you found this, so it's yours. It doesn't belong to me anymore. He's like, no, this is your gold. No, it's not mine. No, it's yours. No, it's not. They're fighting. They are fighting as in who will pass down the gold to the other. Wallahi, something, wallahi, if it was not a hadith, okay, that is authentic, I would have not shared it with you. I'm like, this is la yu'qal. How is that possible? There are people like that? Yes, there are. May Allah protect us. May Allah forgive us. May Allah increase our taqwa and our faithfulness. Ya Rabb, al-wafa bil-uhud. Wa awfu bil-uquud, right? So then they were fighting until they went to court. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Yatahakamu. Faja'a rajul yahkumu baynahum. To judge between them. So they were fighting. No, it belongs to him. No, it belongs to him. He said, listen. Any of you has a young man who wants to get married, available for marriage. So one of the two families says, yes, I have a son. Then he says, any of you have a girl who is wanting to get married at the age of marriage and is available? So the other family said, I have a girl. So the other one has a boy, the other has a girl. So this man judged. Besides fighting, use this gold to get your son married to your daughter, and whatever, for example, remained or so, وتصدقَ, and perhaps give it in charity and so on. So they got the people married. So brothers and sisters, you see the barakah of al-wafa. They died maybe thousands years ago, Allahu A'lam, but their story lives and will continue to live. May Allah allow us to see wonderful people like that in Jannah, Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Brothers and sisters, I want to ask you a question. We spoke about house for sale. We spoke about the battle. What's the grandest, most important contract humans have to fulfill? Amongst us, you have contracts. I got contract with my company that I work for, my engineering company, not mine, I own it, I work for, I have a contract, right? I teach with an institution, I have a contract. What's the most valuable contract? Which is it? What is it? Yalla, bismillah, please, speak within among yourselves or by yourself. Think, what's the most important contract between human beings? The most important contract, it is, what is it? What is it? It is the marriage contract. The number one most important contract between human beings is عقد الزواج, الأولوية. Let's hear the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, أحق الشروط أن توفوا به, the most worthy conditions. From among all the conditions out there, the one that the greatest ones you have to fulfill, ما استحللتم به الفروج, is the marriage contract. How are we with that? When we got married, may Allah make all those who are single have a righteous spouse. Ameen. When we got married, we agreed that we will treat one another according to what is pleasing to Allah, according to the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah. How are we doing, brothers and sisters? How is it? How is our contract relationship? How is the dowry? Did we fulfill it? Are we still struggling? May Allah forgive us and protect us. Where is the promise that you gave to her father? When you got married to her, he said, I'll take care of her. And I promise, inshallah, I will not hurt her. I will not oppress her. Where is that? Where is that contract? What will we do in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's why, brothers and sisters, Rasulullah was very, very tough, especially on the men. Yes, this contract, this hadith, applies for men and women. Yeah, the man has duties over his wife. I got to spend on you. I got to make sure I get a place to stay at. I have to make sure I educate you. Yes, I got to make sure if I had to pay for a tuition or anything like that. Yes, Allah says, قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. Educate, protect your family. That's your job as a husband. And the job of the wife. You know, you work together. For example, the husband says, I don't want such and such individual to come to our house. You try to work it out. You honor their request, right? So then you try your best. Let's say he says, my request is that you don't leave until, just give me a heads up, give me a call. You work things out. You do your own contract in a way that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't put conditions that are haram. But because, brothers and sisters, especially us men, may Allah protect us and forgive us, if we don't fulfill that major contract, that faithfulness towards the spouse, the wife, the one who will stand against us yawm al-qiyamah, next to our spouse, our wife, defending her. Who is it? It will be Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, إِنِّ أُحَرِّجُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَقَّ الضَّعِفَيْنِ. I warn you, I threaten you, تَهْدِيد وَوَعِيد, to the ones who oppress the woman. And he says, وَالْيَتِيم, the orphan. May Allah protect us and forgive us, brothers and sisters. So be aware of that, be aware of that, be aware of that. And to come to an end, brothers and sisters, on this very important topic, inshallah, we end with very important points as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want to go revolve around taqwa as well. He says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. This is min ajmal thamarat al-taqwa, one of the most beautiful things of taqwa. Brother, you speak about taqwa, then you speak about faithfulness. No, they come hand in hand. They're not, don't be confused. Taqwa and faithfulness come hand in hand. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. In tattaqullah, Allah says, if you are God conscious, mindful of Allah, yaj'al lakum furqana. Allah will make things clear for you. You say, brother, there's a lot of fitna. Fitna shubuhat. I don't know what to do. Should I do this? Should I do that? Yaj'al lakum furqana. Allah will make things clear for you. Allahu Akbar. ويكفر عنكم سيئاتكم, and will forgive your sins, ويغفر لكم, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish you يوم القيامة for it. والله ذو الفضل العظيم, and Allah has so much فضل and blessings. آمين رب. May Allah grant it to all of us. آمين رب العالمين. يجعل لكم فرقانا. May Allah allow you all to have clarity. Say آمين. Brothers and sisters, now we go to يوم القيامة, and there's a scene Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, which is very tough. Very tough scene, and I will not be shy to say it. لا حياء في الدين. This hadith is very, very explicit, and I will say it as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said it. And there's nothing funny about it, just to make sure that we are all aware of that. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لكل غادر, and الغدر هو عكس الوفاء, treachery, unfaithfulness, for every unfaithful human being, man, woman, لكل غادر لواء يوم القيامة. The one who is unfaithful will carry a banner, a flag, on the Day of Judgment. يُرْفَعُ لَهُ بِقَدْرِ غَدْرِهِ. The size of the pole or the flag, حجم العلم, okay, حجم اللواء على حجم الغدرة. As big as the treachery. أَلَا وَلَا غَادِرَ أَعْظَمْ غَدْرًا مِنْ أَمِيرٍ عَامَّةٍ. أَمِيرِ عَامَّةٍ. The worst of all is when there is a leader, a king, a prince, a president, a manager, someone who is managing over people, that these people have the worst of pulls, okay, that is resembling their treachery. طيب, where is that pull? أين يكون هذا اللواء؟ هل يمسكه بيده؟ Where is this pole, that flag? Will he be holding it, like that banner? Rasulullah Hassan says, لِكُلِّ غَادِرْ لِوَاءٌ عِنْدَ إِسْتِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the banner, that flag, will be placed in the buttocks of that individual. Hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, authentic narration. An absolute embarrassment. May Allah protect us and grant us the ability to fulfill our promises, fulfill our contracts, Ameen Rabbil Alameen. And we'll remind you of the advice of the Rasulullah and end with this nasiha. Rasulullah Sallam told one of the Sahaba, what did he tell him? He told one of the Sahaba, اتق الله حيثما كنت. Be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you may be, wherever you may go. You travel from Detroit to Chicago, no one knows you in Chicago, right? But fear Allah, Allah is watching you. Be faithful to the spouse that you left behind. Be faithful to your children. Be faithful to Allah Jalla Jalaluh. اتق الله حيثما كنت. واتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها. And whenever you commit a sin, be sure to commit a good deed. Why? To erase the bad sin. وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. And treat people with good manners. Brothers and sisters, this was the advice of the Prophet ﷺ. I tried to end with all of you. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be conscious of Allah. Fulfill your promises. Yalla, bismillah. You broke previous promises. Fix it now. Some contracts you breached. Seek forgiveness. Try to make up for it. You owe someone money. Please pay it back on the due date, inshallah. May Allah bless you all. May Allah make you all of al-muttaqeen, the ones whom Allah loves. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa jazakumullahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.